Over in El Salvador, thousands of people took to the streets to protest against President Nayib Bukele over a wide range of issues. Here's the full story.
Thousands marched in El Salvador on Sunday to air a range of grievances against President Nayib Bukele, from adopting Bitcoin as legal tender to firing Supreme Court judges, which has been viewed by his critics as a power grab. At least 4,000 people took to the streets in San Salvador, according to estimates by local media. Some carried banners and signs rejecting Bitcoin, which officially became legal tender in the Central American country in September. Others opposed the potential for Bukele to seek a second consecutive term. Near the capital's main square, protesters set fire to a doll bearing the likeness of the 40-year-old president. Last month, Bukele proclaimed himself dictator of El Salvador on his Twitter in an apparent joke amid concerns about his increasing concentration of power. In May, a Congress dominated for the first time by Bukele's New Ideas Party voted to fire the judges on the constitutional panel of the Supreme Court, among the most senior jurists in the country. Replacements seen as friendly to the president were then swiftly voted in, which generated harsh criticism from the United States as well as top international rights groups. Bukele, a seasoned and often provocative user of social media, dismissed Sunday's protests on Twitter, saying, quote, "The march is a failure, and they know it."
Former U.S. President Bill Clinton heads home after spending 5 nights at a Southern California hospital. The details in this report.
Former U.S. President Bill Clinton walked out of a Southern California hospital on Sunday. He was admitted last week for a urological infection and will continue receiving treatment in his home state of New York. Asked how he was feeling as he exited, the 75-year-old former president gave reporters a thumbs up. The former president had been in California for an event for his foundation and was admitted to the UC Irvine Medical Center's intensive care unit after suffering from fatigue on Tuesday. Dr. Alpesh Amin, who had been overseeing his care at the hospital, said in a statement Clinton was discharged after his fever and white blood cell count had normalized and would finish his course of antibiotics at home in New York. Clinton, who has had previous heart problems, held the White House from 1993 to 2001. After leaving office, he had a quadruple bypass operation in 2004 and a procedure to open a blocked artery in 2010. He left the hospital accompanied by his wife, former Secretary of State, and 2016 Democratic presidential nominee Hillary Clinton. She waved before the pair departed in a motorcade.
Dozens of people dead as heavy rains trigger flooding and landslides in India's Kerala state. More in this report.
Landslides and floods claimed dozens of lives in India's southern state of Kerala over the weekend. In hard-hit Kottayam, rescuers raced to clear debris from a bridge with an excavator. A resident described the extent of the damage.
There are four landslides happened there yesterday. The hill behind me, which has brought all the water and other items to the downwards. There are five shops here. This is totally washed out.
The Indian Army and Navy were sent to Kottayam and Idukki districts to aid rescue efforts. Annual rainfall supports two-thirds of India's billion-plus population who live in rural areas and rely on farming. However, excessive rainfall sparks not only floods and landslides, but also waterborne diseases. In 2018, Kerala saw some of its worst floods in the century. They killed at least 400 people and displaced 200,000 more.